Good afternoon, and welcome to the commencement exercises for the Salem High School Class of 2020. On behalf of the entire Salem High School faculty and the senior class, it is my pleasure to welcome you. If I have not had an opportunity to meet you in the past, my name is Scott Habib, and one of the great honors of my life is I have the privilege of serving as the principal of this community's high school. What a crazy year it's been, right? Who would have ever thought at the beginning of this school year that this is the way we would have finished it? But we've made it. Class of 2020, we have worked very hard to let you know just how much we love and appreciate you. And we have gone to great lengths to create in two graduation ceremonies all of the best elements of our traditional graduation ceremonies. Plus, we've been able to add in some things that we can't do under normal circumstances. We hope you'll enjoy these ceremonies and recognize that everything about them are designed to show you that we love you. Now, if we were in a traditional ceremony, at this time, everyone would stand as the class processed in. So let's make this not just virtual, let's make it a little participatory. So wherever you are right now, at home or wherever you are watching this, please stand with me and let's welcome the Salem High School Class of 2020. Thank you. It's been 3 months now, but it's still hard to fathom the situation we find ourselves in today. Normally, we would be gathered together in a large group at the Salem Civic Center. Today, we are gathered in small groups, in our homes, watching on YouTube virtually. And let's be honest, friends, it just doesn't feel the same, does it? I get it. But let's remember this. While this may not feel the same as a normal graduation, it is still a celebration, and we have much to celebrate. Today, we get to celebrate the accomplishments of approximately 285 young people. You all have been on a journey for 13 years, and now you're ready. You're ready to go on to that next leg of your journey. We celebrate all that you have accomplished. We celebrate all that you have done, and frankly, we celebrate all that you have endured. Not even a global pandemic could prevent you from finishing the most difficult senior year in history. Class of 2020, we celebrate you and we salute you. Before we go any further with today's celebration, there are several other individuals who have asked for an opportunity to salute you.
Hello, Salem. I'm James Martin with Salem City Council, Salem High School, class of 1991. I'm here today to congratulate you on your achievement, Salem High School, class of 2020. I wish you the very best in everything you do. Go Salem.
Hi, I'm Jane Johnson, your vice mayor. I'd like to quote a great visionary, Dr. Seuss. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so be on your way. I hope no matter where you roam, class of 2020, that you'll always come home to Salem. Best wishes and congratulations. Job well done.
Hello, I'm City Councilman Bill Jones, lifelong resident of the City of Salem and a graduate of Glenver High School in 1977. I'd like to take this opportunity to congratulate all the seniors at Salem High School this year. Through all the obstacles you've been through and all the mountains you've climbed, I say thank you for what you've done for this community and what you're going to do in the future. God bless you and best of luck to you.
Hello, graduates. I'm Mayor Randy Foley, Salem High School class of 1987. I developed many great friendships in high school, and those relationships exist to this day. You've endured much during this year, and although it's been difficult, it should help you with the inevitable obstacles you will have to overcome in the future. Best of luck and Godspeed.
This is Councilman John Saunders wishing the class of 2020 of Salem High School good luck in their future endeavors. I was a 1978 graduate of the first inaugural class of this Salem High School. 539 graduates. It took over 4 hours. Delayed my beach trip for at least 2 hours afterwards before we could get out of that Civic Center. So I wish each and every one of you the best of luck in the near future.
Hi, I'm Bud Foster, longtime defensive coordinator for the Virginia Tech Hokies. I want to congratulate the Salem High School class of 2020. When I think of Salem High School, I think of a rich tradition, both academically and athletically. You are prepared for the next chapter life brings your way. My challenge to you is, be your best version of yourself every day. Again, congratulations, and I want to wish you nothing but the very best.
Congratulations to all the high school graduates out there. My name is Coach Bennett. I'm the head coach at the University of Virginia, and sincerely wishing you the best, whether it's going on to college or whatever it is you're going to do. A job well done to get through high school. And you guys are our future. We need you, and I know the future's bright. So again, I wish you the best, and congratulations on this impressive accomplishment.
Hi, this is Mike Young, head basketball coach at Virginia Tech. I want to congratulate the 2020 graduating class of Salem High School. I wish each of you the very best in all of your future endeavors. Go Spartans!
I'm Morgan Griffith, and I'm very proud to represent Salem and the rest of the 9th Congressional District in the United States Congress. I wanted to say congratulations to our Salem High School 2020 grads. We know you've done great things up to this point, and we know as you move forward, whether it be college, trade school, or just whatever it is you choose, that you're going to be a great success. So I say congratulations to each and every one of you. May God bless you, and may you continue to make Salem proud.
Congratulations to the Salem High School Class of 2020. You've worked hard to achieve your goals. Chase your dreams with effort, passion, and hard work. And in the words of country singer Tim McGraw, always stay humble and kind.
The Salem City School Board will not be on the front row at your graduation this year as we normally are. We'd really prefer that you have your teachers and administrators, the folks that have impacted your time at Salem High School there, to give you your diploma and congratulate you on this accomplishment.
Though we know virtual classes on Zoom, a canceled prom, and drive-through graduation were not what you envisioned as you look towards your last year of high school, please know this does not lessen your accomplishment.
Congratulations, senior graduating class of Salem High School. We are so proud of you. Now, there are a few words of wisdom we would like to share with you in the hope that you will embrace the mission of Salem City Schools to love, engage, and inspire as you go forward into your future plans.
While your lives have been turned upside down this year, much like your high school, there are three things I'd like to share with you that might help to turn them right side up. First, love like never before. The world is filled with new friends and teachers. Look for them. Second, engage like never before. Remember how Salem came together in amazing ways this year. Third, inspire like never before. Fear vanishes when inspiration is present.
Our hopes for your future are that you will take lessons from this crazy time that lasts a lifetime. Lessons on coming together, to fight a common cause, adapting to difficult circumstances, and making the best of any given situation. Congratulations, class of 2020. Go forward to love, engage, and inspire others.
Class of 2020, there is so much to celebrate today. But the reality is we are celebrating more than just our graduates. In fact, we are celebrating an entire community. Our young people know they did not get where they are completely on their own, even though they worked hard. Their lives are a result of many people who have sacrificed on their behalf. Parents and grandparents, scout leaders, pastors, coaches, neighbors, friends. The class of 2020 would not be where it is today if you had not loved them the way you have. So before we go any further, graduates, another chance to get participatory. Right now it's time for us to pause and for you to say thank you to the people who love you and have gotten you where you are today. Go ahead, I mean it. Well, I'm gonna pause and stare awkwardly at this camera while you turn and say thank you and maybe even give a hug to the people around you. No, I really mean it. Let's do it. I'm still waiting for a few of you. Come on now, say thank you. And on their behalf, I thank all of you for what you have done. At Salem High School, we start all events by taking time to remember how blessed we are to live in this nation. It's by no means a perfect nation, and it never will be. And lately, some of those imperfections have been front and center. But this is still a place where we are free. This is a place where good people, through hard work, determination, and even protests at times, are able to make life better for everyone around us. So to honor those who have gone before us, to give us the right to be gathered today, even though it's virtually, we are going to begin this ceremony with a Pledge of Allegiance. Ms. Berkeley Wall, our SCA president, will now lead us in the pledge. I would ask you, wherever you are, wherever you're watching this, to please stand. If you're wearing a hat, I would ask you to please remove your hat as we recite together the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Berkeley. At this time, we're going to get to hear from Berkeley once again. Berkeley has served wonderfully in her role as our SCA president this year. She's an outstanding leader and young person. And at this time, she will share an invocation. Berkeley?
Good afternoon. It is my privilege to welcome all of you to this celebration of the Salem High School Class of 2020. Today, we celebrate each student,
each bright young mind who has shaped our class and contributed immensely to the Spartan community during their time here in Salem. Today, I also welcome and celebrate those who have helped us along to this point. With the utmost gratitude, I thank each and every individual who has dedicated their time, their knowledge, and their unconditional support to the graduating members of our class. Thank you to my fellow seniors, our educators, our guardians, and this community for all you have done for us during our school experiences. With your help and guidance, together we get to share in this opportunity of celebration for the class of 2020. Today, we reflect on and celebrate each of the little moments that brought us here together. Those cheesy teacher jokes we're ashamed to admit we laughed at. The late nights we spent up because we procrastinated to a daring degree. That one or several really bad days when we thought we wouldn't make it here. And all of the many lessons in between that we learned both home and at school over the years. And on this day, given the unusual circumstances of our graduation, our front row seating couch graduation, I'm reminded of one lesson in particular from my freshman year. In second semester, Mr. Snyder's psychology class, he taught us about the social psychologist Milgram, best known for his controversial obedience studies. Outside of obedience, Milgram also wanted to study the connection between people. So he thought of how hard would it be to send a letter to a complete stranger across the country. So say I give you a letter, and you give it to a friend who gives it to a friend who gives it to a friend. Would the letter ever reach the intended stranger on the other side of the country? Milgram wanted to find out. Mr. Snyder told us that Milgram's experiment not only worked, but unexpectedly, it took on average only 6 attempts for these letters to arrive at their intended strangers, even with some on occasion arriving in just 2 attempts. Meaning Milgram's results shows that one person is less than a handful of connections away from a million new people. Milgram's work shows how intertwined we all are with one another. The spread of the virus that keeps us apart in this moment resembles our ability to reach out and connect with someone across the country, even across the world. At any moment, we are just one person away from 100 new people. Today, I welcome each of you to a celebration of 286 students who are headed out into the world to impact so many more lives than you and I can count in each day to come. Whether you're headed to work, to college, or to admirably serve our nation, I am so excited to know you will be sharing your kindness, your strengths, and your goodness with so many. Your voice and your passions will spread across the world faster than imaginable. Welcome, class of 2020, to your new beginning.
Once again, thank you, Berkeley, and thank you for being an outstanding leader during your 4 years here at Salem High School. At this time, we're going to recognize 4 very special members of the Salem High School faculty. Mr. Bolte, Ms. Vernon, Ms. Stratton, and Ms. Gardner. They're retiring this year. Between the 4 of them, they have given 130 plus years of service to young people, and they are outstanding teachers. If you have had the privilege of being in one of their classrooms, then you have had the privilege of being around someone who is passionate about what they do. But there's more than just great teaching and passion involved in these 4 individuals. Young people, graduates, I want you to learn a lesson from the life of Ms. Stratton, the life of Ms. Gardner, the life of Mr. Bolte, and the life of Ms. Vernon. They have chosen to live a life of service to others, and they have had a tremendous impact as a result. If you want to have a life that has meaning and purpose, if you want to live a great story, graduates, here's the lesson. Whatever it is you choose to do, live your life in the service of others. If you decide that your life is not about you, but instead your life is about how you will impact others and serve others, I promise you, you will find meaning in whatever it is you do. So thank you, Ms. Vernon, Ms. Gardner, Ms. Stratton, and Mr. Bolte. Thank you for giving away your lives so that countless young people can find theirs. We salute you, and we are thankful for the model you have set and for all the years you have given to young people. Thank you. It is an honor to be part of a community like this because it truly is a family. It's more than a community, it's a family. And at this time, I would like to welcome the head of the Spartan family, Dr. Alan Siebert, our superintendent, who has some remarks for the class of 2020. And I also want to say, Dr. Siebert, thank you for the model you set for us every day, not just through this pandemic, but every day of reminding us that we truly are a family. Dr. Siebert?
Greetings, my name is Alan Siebert, and I serve as division superintendent in Salem City Schools. On behalf of the City of Salem School Board and all who serve young people in the City of Salem Schools, I offer a warm welcome and congratulations. I've been attending Salem High School commencement for nearly 3 decades, but this is an extra special commencement because Michelle and I are proud parents of a member of the class of 2020. So to the graduates and their families, please know that we understand. We have been walking this road with you. Special thanks to the Graduation Arrangements Committee and tomorrow to the staff at the Salem Civic Center for having been very creative and working very hard to make this commencement every bit as special and meaningful as it is historically significant at this point in time. The global pandemic and the resulting school closure are evidence of an enduring truth. While we cannot often choose our circumstances, we can choose how we respond. While we all miss things lost during the pandemic, we can also choose to be thankful for opportunities when we encounter them. I miss the tradition and scope of commencement with thousands in attendance at the Salem Civic Center. I miss the family members from far away who ordinarily would have traveled here to Salem to celebrate. But there are opportunities, for more of our family members than could have ever made the trip to have the opportunity to view this broadcast. And by pre-recording these remarks, I have the opportunity to sit alongside my family with our graduate. Class of 2020, thank you for inspiring our community. You've experienced a number of harsh realities in rapid succession. You have conducted yourselves admirably, even as you've had so many things canceled. Spring athletics and activities canceled, prom canceled, senior awards assembly canceled, senior day and twister tournament canceled, senior skip day canceled. At least to my knowledge, you seniors never tell us about that particular unsanctioned event. Indeed, there have been more things canceled, but as I said, you have inspired us. During the weekend after the statewide school closure was announced on March 13th, during the weekend, I received emails from members of this Salem High School class of 2020, not about prom or Twister, but asking how to help. Asking how you could help with meal deliveries, how you could help with childcare for essential workers, how to help one another celebrate in different ways. Yes, some things were canceled, but many things were not canceled. Class of 2020 commencement, not canceled. Class of 2020 senior spirit, not canceled. Your compassion for others, not canceled. The investment of your teachers and school staff, not canceled. The love of your families, not canceled. Hope, engagement, and your very bright futures, all definitely not canceled. As mentioned, many of our family members are participating today, both near and far. In our family's faith tradition, like many others, there's an appreciation of the Serenity Prayer, a prayer for the serenity to accept the things we cannot change and the courage to change the things we can. You have navigated elementary school, middle school, and are now graduating in a very unusual and difficult time. But I encourage you to look for opportunities in the midst of extreme challenges. You have the opportunity to grow personally and collectively through disappointments, by accepting things you cannot change, even losing things that everyone felt entitled to that have since been lost without warning. But that acceptance doesn't mean being passive. On the contrary, your resilience proves that creativity, patience, and teamwork can lead to a different, but still very rewarding path. You have indeed encountered the opportunity to change the things you can. to evaluate current events, to consider the perspectives of others, to reflect upon and live out your values. Living your values is always important, but we are clearly in the midst of a difficult and challenging point in history. But we can choose as individuals, as a community, as a nation, to become better. Graduates, we who love you regret that your senior year coincided with a very difficult point in human history. But we believe in you. In fact, we are counting on you to make our world better. When LeBron James recently addressed the class of 2020 as part of the Graduate Together event, his message included, stay close to home, maybe not physically, but in every other way possible. Pursue every ambition, go as far as you can possibly dream, and be the first generation to embrace a new responsibility, a responsibility to rebuild your community. Class of 2020, the world has changed. You will determine how we rebuild. Make your community a priority. If we're going to cancel something, let's cancel the return to normal people are talking about. Instead, let's show that we've learned something from all of this. Let's resolve to return to better. Better priorities, better use of time, better emphasis on relationships, better appreciation for the people and occupations we all rely on, better understanding of the interconnectedness of humankind. As is my custom for nearly 15 years at this event, I will conclude with the words of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., a quote about greatness. He said, anyone can be great because anyone can serve. You just need a heart full of grace and a soul generated by love. Therefore, class of 2020, including Logan, David, Siebert, I do not wish you good luck. Instead, I wish you a heart full of grace and a soul generated by love. I wish you greatness. Thank you, and may God bless the Salem High School class of 2020.
Thank you, Dr. Siebert, for those remarks. At this time, we would like to recognize two very special members of the class of 2020. Autumn Shoup and Sam Scutt have decided that the next leg of their lives' journeys will be served in the United States Marine Corps. Autumn and Sam, we salute you, and we want you to know how appreciative we are for your decision to serve this way. We know that the nation we live in would not be the nation it is if people before you had not made this decision. And we know that your decision to serve in the United States Marine Corps, it will help ensure that this nation stays the great place it is today for years to come. Autumn and Sam, thank you very much. You know, we have a school filled with talented young people. And when those talented young people connect with wonderful teachers, it's amazing what gets created. As I mentioned earlier, Ms. Christy Vernon is retiring this year, but no Salem High School graduation would be complete without a performance by members of our Salem Singers. And so now, under the conduction of Ms. Christy Vernon, I present to you the Salem Singers. The senior members are BJ Arms, Eliza Bain, Carolina Bowen, Christian Crawley, Autumn Goff, Riley Lawrence, and David Patterson. They will be performing a song called Why We Sing by Greg Gilpin. And there's a little special treat thrown in there that was arranged by Ms. Vernon for all members of the Salem community. At this time, I give you the Salem High School Salem Singers.
A sound of hope, a sound of peace.
A sound that celebrates and speaks what we believe.
A sound of love,
a sound so strong.
It's amazing what is given when we share a song. This is why we sing, why we lift our voice. Why we stand as one in harmony.
Harmony.
This is why we sing, why we lift our voice. Take my hand and sing with me. Music builds a bridge, it can tear down a wall. Music that can speak to one and all. This is why we sing, why we lift our voice, why we stand as one in harmony. This is why we sing, why we lift our voice. Take my hand and sing with me.
Wow. Salem Singers, thank you. Miss Vernon, thank you for putting that together. I also need to recognize Flat 5 Recording Studio for their help in recording that. That's not easy to do during a pandemic. And also Mr. Jeff Hoffman for the videography. Folks, we live in an amazing community. And Miss Vernon, what a great opus as you retire. Thank you for that gift. Now it's time to hear from some other members of the senior class in what we call our distinguished scholar speeches. So at Salem High School, we don't use class rank. We don't want kids competing against each other. We want them collaborating so they all work together for the common good. But what we've done for the last two decades is if a student has above a 4.0 at the end of the first semester of their senior year, they are declared to be distinguished scholars. That group of students can then apply to be a graduation speaker. Ms. Pam Carter leads that process, and thank you, Ms. Carter, for the hard work you do there. And a panel of teachers will select two distinguished scholars to speak at graduation. At this point, we have the pleasure of being addressed by them. And the first distinguished scholar who you will hear from is Ms. Regan Laughlin. Regan?
When we were in elementary school, graduating from high school seemed like such a daunting task, and in some ways it would be. We would have many projects, tests, field trips, SOLs, SATs, college applications, scholarship applications, dances, and let us not forget COVID-19 to conquer before we would come to this day. When I was little, I never thought much about high school or graduating. I didn't have older siblings to look up to and learn from. My cousins all graduated when I was young, and I'll be honest, at that age, I really cared more about my American Girl dolls and Barbies. When we started school, we were young, inexperienced, not strong in many ways, and needed constant guidance. Like a young tree sapling growing into a strong tree, we needed to develop our root system, and we also needed a few supportive stakes and some pruning of our branches to grow into the independent, strong adults those close to us knew we could be. Now, 13 years later, as I look at my fellow classmates, I know that we, the class of 2020, have become stronger every year because of our roots and the support system we have around us today and throughout our years in Salem. A tree's root system not only helps it to grow stronger, but keeps it grounded as well. We each have a complex and strong support system, and that support starts at home for many of us. Our families are there to cheer us on and push us to do our best. I remember moving to South Salem in second grade. I was scared, nervous, and worried that my new school would leave me feeling unsupported and alone like my previous school. I quickly learned, however, that the adults in South Salem wanted to cheer me on and see me succeed. Mrs. Humphrey always met us with a smile, a hug, and an encouraging word for the day. I know my experience was duplicated in each of our four elementary schools around Salem. As we have grown, so have our root systems. Our roots have expanded beyond just our families to include friends, members of the community, coaches, employers, and our teachers. Like a growing tree needing support stakes to stand tall, we have also needed people to hold us up as we developed our independence. These persons have taken on different roles over the years. Some have been teachers, mentors, close friends you've known since Ms. Sheila's, a friend you were close with in elementary school and then reconnected with in high school, your brother, your cousins, or your parents. Our supporters want us to grow to be stronger, stand taller, and be better than we were before. I've had the good fortune to have Mrs. Pitts as my teacher two consecutive years for IB Biology 1 and 2. Even though I also knew her outside of school, the first year in her classroom, I not only learned about cells and classification, but I also learned that I could talk to her about anything. At the end of that first year, I learned that Mrs. Pitts knew me well and knew what I needed to succeed and achieve my goal of becoming a radiography technician. As we have grown, we have made mistakes, taken risks, forgotten our goals, or stopped believing in ourselves. Someone or several someones have been there along the way to guide us back. Like that growing tree, we have needed a little pruning to ensure we finish strong on this path that started 13 years ago. Since ninth grade, one staff member at times has known me better than I have known myself. Miss Nelson has seen an ability in me that I sometimes had forgotten I have. She has been there to encourage me to keep moving forward. She will be a voice that I will take with me beyond the walls of Salem High School. My wish for each of you, class of 2020, is that as we graduate and continue to deepen our roots, we find someone like Mrs. Pitts or Miss Nelson who constantly supports us to be the best version of ourselves that we can be. The Canadian philosopher Matsuna Dewaro stated, "It is in the roots, not the branches, that a tree's greatest strength lies." We are stronger because of the roots we have developed over the years in Salem City Schools. Our parents, families, teachers, mentors, and friends have provided us with the guidance, encouragement, and redirection necessary to expand our roots and grow strong. Class of 2020, we are ready, we are strong, and we will continue to make a difference in the lives of those around us and in the world in which we live. As we go forward, remember the words of Victor Hugo. Change your opinions, keep to your principles. Change your leaves. Keep intact your roots. Thank you.
Thank you, Regan. Nice job. Folks, now we have the honor of being addressed by our second distinguished scholar speaker, Miss Emma Painter. Emma?
I don't know about anyone else, but my greatest fear is falling from extreme heights and thinking that I'm going to hit the ground. Even in video games, I get scared. Scared of falling? And hitting the virtual ground. So naturally, I decided that for my 18th birthday, I would go skydiving. Yeah, great idea. So while I await that day, I've done a lot of thinking about skydiving. Getting to the place, going up in the plane, then finally looking over the edge to my doom. Now, if I want to go skydiving, I have to be willing to take that risk. But I can't do it without anyone's help. But if I do take that risk, I'm balancing on the edge of a greater reward. When we take that jump from the plane, the world looks a whole lot different. You never really see the world from above falling face first into it. When we go out into the world, it's similar to this, because we have a whole new perspective. And because of that, we can change the world for the better. Our new perspective is COVID. And what we've learned with the world being shut down. During this time, we've come together to support each other with our very bad senioritis. That's even worse because we're at home. But also our non-tech savvy teachers and our community. We are learning to fly before we even jump. Chris Dyer, the 2020 Louisiana Teacher of the Year, said it perfectly, that the people our age are resilient and innovative. And that is exactly what we are. This resilience and innovation that we've learned through COVID and high school, and the risk that it's put us through, is going to take us and the world into the future. The world as we knew it was broken, just like most things. But the great gift of humanity is the ability to fix broken things. Think about the Great Depression, rebuilding after World War II, and the Civil Rights Movement, which helped change the whole world's mindset. We can balance our futures around something that has been fixed if we're willing to walk out of our comfort zone, taking that risk with the parachutes of skills and connections strapped tight. Now, no one ever did anything without someone's help. And you definitely cannot go skydiving without help. It takes a whole team of people just to prepare you to go jump out of the plane. You have your instructor who prepares you with the skills you need in order to jump. You have your ground support, aka your cheerleaders, who tell you you're going to have so much fun. Then you have your pilot, who navigates you to the place where you jump out. And don't forget the people who are checking the gears, behind the scenes, managing logistics, and fueling the plane, and people. And then finally, you have the person who's going to make that jump with you and pushes you off into the world with a whole new perspective. Who is that person to you? Who are your cheerleaders, your mentors? Whoever these people are in your life, take the time to thank them. Coming into the world or falling out of it, don't ever forget the people who helped you get there and helped you fall and fly at the same time. We will be the first class to enter the world with the impact of coronavirus in our hands. And for many of us, it's made us change our plans entirely and take a whole new risk. But it's opened a new door, the one we're jumping out of. The world doesn't have to be what it was before, and we are given the chance to change it for the better. And we're already starting that change. When I was studying this speech, Ms. Carter told me to look for a success story, but the one I'm looking for and the one I'm waiting for wasn't ready yet. They're still balancing on the edge. They have yet to jump out and are preparing to face and change the world as we know it. The success story I'm waiting for is us, the class of 2020. They always told us we were unique. Now we truly are. And we find ourselves balancing on the edge of graduation, life, and a whole new world, preparing to jump and fly. Which reminds me of why I decided to skydive. The one thing I've always wanted to do was fly, but my greatest fear was falling. And that's a risk I'll have to take, because sometimes falling means flying. Thank you.
Thank you, Emma. And once again, thank you, Regan, as well. Both of you represented the class of 2020 very well today. Thank you very much. Now it's time to award the Yang Q Lee Award. In 1985, the name of the Outstanding Senior Award was changed to the Yang Q Lee Senior Achievement Award. It was named in honor of Yang Q Lee, a 1980 graduate of Salem High School who received the award. Tragically, in 1981, after his freshman year at the University of Virginia, Yang Q Lee lost his life in a traffic accident. Because his life exemplified all that we look for in our young people, the award was forever changed to honor his name and his memory. Every year, his sister, Yang Pei, and her family give us a token to give to that year's recipient. This year's recipient of the Yang Q Lee Senior Achievement Award is Iva Barnes. Iva, congratulations. You are a worthy recipient of this recognition. You know, I asked my daughter, who happens to be in this class, what she thought about Iva. I said I had to write a recommendation for her. I didn't tell my daughter what it was about. And she said, you know, Iva is one person who is kind to everybody. She said, it doesn't matter who you are, what type of person you are, Iva Barnes is a friend to you. Iva, that type of kindness is exactly what we look for in our young people. Thank you so much for the 4 years you have given to us here at Salem High School, and congratulations on your recognition. Well, it is almost time for the recognition of each graduate. At this time, in a traditional ceremony, as we call out your name, you would come across the stage and receive your diploma. That will happen tomorrow at the Salem Civic Center Annex. However, just like in a normal graduation, when we recognize each senior, a slide for that senior will be shown. It will have their picture and their name and several bullet points of information. We asked our seniors to tell us what they would like to have on their slides. So enjoy reading them and seeing where they're going next year and what sort of things they were involved with in high school. You'll also see the words Distinguished Scholar on 57 of these slides. That's right, 57 members of this class had a 4.0 or higher grade point average. Those seniors, tomorrow when they walk across the stage along with their diploma, will also receive a check for $500 from our school board. You will also see on many of these slides the words Salem Ed Foundation or Salem Sports Foundation. That means these seniors received a scholarship from one of these great organizations that for over 30 years have been dedicated to providing scholarships to our students. All right, here we go. Mr. King is going to read out each name, and we will recognize every member of the senior class. Seniors, here's your moment.
Sarah Elizabeth Ehlers. Ellen Lee Anama, Distinguished Scholar. Anthony Michael Anderson. Cortland Taylor Anderson. William Bradley Arms, Jr. Jonathan Alexander Arnold, Distinguished Scholar. Benjamin Thomas Ashwell, Distinguished Scholar. Alyssa Renee Austin. Matthew Todd Bailey. Elizabeth Caroline Bain, Distinguished Scholar. Dan Albert Baker, Jr. Delina Michelle Barber. Cecile Elizabeth Francois Barker. Iva May Barnes. Taylor Ann Barr. Nicholas Gill Basham. Brooke Gentry Baxley. Damian Dallas Bean. Allison Angelique Beard. Cody Nathaniel Beckner. Rihanna Marie Black. Alexander James Blanchard. Alan John Blankenship. Sean David Blevins, Jr. Logan Elliott Betcher, Distinguished Scholar. Davion Lewis Booker. Elizabeth Elaine Boast. Griffin Jonah Boucher. Carolina Michelle Bowen, Distinguished Scholar. Jared Wade Bowles. Caroline Elizabeth Bowman. Matthew Thomas Bowman. Elijah Paul Boyer. James Carlton Bradshaw. Sarah Elizabeth Brauch, Distinguished Scholar. Mackenzie Kate Broderick, Distinguished Scholar. Megan Patricia Brooks. Michaela Angelina Broman, Distinguished Scholar. Tommy Anthony Brown. Corey Seth Bryant. Savannah Nicole Burris. Emily Irina Burton. Stephen Joshua Butler. Caden Spencer Butt. Cameron Jake Buzzard. Dominique Cable. Emma Rachel Kane. Madison Glenn Caldwell, Distinguished Scholar. Jacob Wade Carrico, Distinguished Scholar. Oliver David Castillo Hernandez. Daniel Lee Casto II. Ting Chan, Distinguished Scholar. Jared Seth Cheney. Rachel Grace Chouse, Distinguished Scholar. John Grayson Burks Chisholm, Distinguished Scholar. Cole Stephen Clayton. Aaliyah Kiona Cobbs. Isis Ikira Cobbs. Dylan Alexander Compton. Catherine Jean Conklin, Distinguished Scholar. Hayden Neil Connor. Tyler Arliss Connor. Kendall Lee Cook. Nicholas David Cook. Bryston Alexander Cooper. Camille Francis Cooper. Samuel Joseph Cosnati IV. Annalise Victoria Crawford. Christian Michael Anthony Crawley, Distinguished Scholar. Kathleen Marie Cross, Distinguished Scholar. Zachary Lloyd Cross. Christian James Crowder. Emma Steele Crow, Distinguished Scholar. Richard Fo Dang. Danielle Marie Davis. Peter Noah Taylor Doyot. Sierra Kaylee Deal Morris. Callie Diana Degree. Logan Curtis DeWalt. George Vega Doe. Richard Wayne Dooley.
Christopher Akins Duncan.
Brian Kong Duong, Distinguished Scholar. Anna Elizabeth Eaton. Cameron Page Ellingson. Jennifer Espino, Distinguished Scholar. Catherine Shea Evans. Kyle Reese Evans, Distinguished Scholar. Gabriel O'Brien Fairchilds. Caroline Adele Falber. Chase Christopher Ferris. Jaden Andrew Fetro, Distinguished Scholar. Serena Elise Fick, Distinguished Scholar. Jada Kiss Lamar Finney. Anna Claire Fleener, Distinguished Scholar. Timothy Andrew Fleshman. Madison Taylor Fountain. Jada Love Fox, Distinguished Scholar. Maya Bakit Frankie. Joseph Allen Frazier, Distinguished Scholar. Morgan Bethany Frost. Preston Rock Furman. Emmeline Melissa Garcia Escalante. Brianna Isabella Gentilini. Autumn Michelle Goff. Anne Hurley Del Carmen Gonzalez. Hunter James Grepiotis. Nathaniel Zane Grubb. Genevieve Karen Guntram Forster. Matthew Dylan Guthrie. McKenna Reagan Habib, Distinguished Scholar.
Eden Trinity Hall.
Madison Laurel Hall, Distinguished Scholar. Brooklyn Ilea Harper. Meg Ann Harris, Distinguished Scholar. Andrew Joseph Harrison. Marley Elizabeth Hart, Distinguished Scholar. Cheyenne Nicole Hawkins. James Houston Reese Hayes. Ryan Dennis Headley. Aaron Brooke Helton. Meredith Lee Hicks, Distinguished Scholar. Heaven Mackenzie Hill. Zian Burks Honecker. Scott Jacob Honeycutt, Distinguished Scholar. Hannah Allison Hooker.
Roy Robert Howard Jr.
Richard Gray Howard. Zachary Matthew Hoyer. Jack Thomas Harding Hudson. Lydia May Huffman. Tyler Nathaniel Huffman. Russell Wesley Huggett. Tajiana Monet Hunt. Anne Elizabeth Hurley, Distinguished Scholar. Matthew Dade Hutchison. Alyssa Brooke Ingerson, Distinguished Scholar. Benjamin Aaron James. Matthew Vaughn Edward Jeffries. Adam Robert Jones. Kevin Duncan Jones. Tyler Logan Jones. Grace Nicole Kelly. Lillian Mary Kilner. Mary Matlin King, Distinguished Scholar. Kennedy Elizabeth LaFon. Kayla Bridget Lyonnaise. Kira Ann Lant. Regan Ray Shepherd Laughlin. Joseph Logan Lavis. Riley Ann Lawrence. Nicholas Algren Lawson. Jacob Randolph Legere. Seth Daniel Lemon. Annie Grace Lester.
Charles Arthur Lewis.
Darius Julian Brishon Lewis. Jeremy Allen Scott Lilly. Bailey Michelle Littner. James Wallace Lively. Isis Donia Madden. Tatiana Michelle Madison. Cassidy Marie Martin. Abigail Lane Mason, Distinguished Scholar. Alexander Riker McClintock. Riley Elizabeth McLean. Jonas Mason Malozzi. Marilyn Lisbeth Lara Mendoza. James Carden Miles. Abigail Tegan Moore. Thomas Andrew Moore. Aaliyah Rain Morgan. Michael Aaron Morrison. Adam Christopher Morton. Benjamin Douglas Miles. Jeremy Allison Muncy. Aaron Thomas Murphy, Distinguished Scholar. Christopher Luke Murphy. Colleen Elizabeth Murphy, Distinguished Scholar. Bruce Allen Musgrove. Elizabeth Talia Musselman, Distinguished Scholar. Travis Daniel Musselman. Christian Stone Myers. Benjamin Harrison Newman, Distinguished Scholar. Faith Noel Nemo. Hayden Lee Ollis. Isabella Reese Owen. Jordan Thomas Owens. Emma Huffman Painter, Distinguished Scholar. Michael James Panza. Madison Ashley Parrish. Ganesham Suresh Patel. Nishi Hiran Kumar Patel. Andy Christine Patterson. David Lee Patterson. James Alfred Penix II. Isaiah McKinley Persinger. Carrie Jane Peters, Distinguished Scholar. Claire Elizabeth Peterson, Distinguished Scholar. Robert Anthony Pinello. Caleb Deshaun Powers. Lance Andrew Price. Haley Sheehan Rains. Seth Preston Rakes. James Alexander Rashkovsky. Maya P. Reddy, Distinguished Scholar. Caroline Grace Reed. Luke Everett Reed. Hayden Lewis Rice. Madison Riley Richardson. William Shepherd Roberts III. Daryl Lavelle Robertson Jr. Zeth Gabriel Robertson. Samuel Lawrence Robinson. Taisha Lasha Robinson. Andy B. Rodriguez. Josie Delaney Roop. Tanner Catherine Rowe, Distinguished Scholar. Sydney Thomas Royal. Alexander Orion Royston. Shelley Salinas McGill. Taylor Marie Scales. Rachel Maggie Schmidt, Distinguished Scholar. Bryson Maxwell Schneier. Della Ray Scott. Samuel Owen Scutt. Logan David Siebert. John Lee Selby. Ethan Robert Shaw, Distinguished Scholar. Atlas Simone Shea Gangloff. Amaris Lee Shepherd. Dakota James Short. Autumn Marie Shoup. Joshua Daniel Silva. Wilda Simeon. Gurleen Carr Singh. Walter Braden Sluss. Annalise Michelle Smith. Austin Blake Smith. Evan Christopher Smith. Haley Marie Smith. Jessica Morgan Smith. Kinsey Taylor Smith. Madison Renee Souter. Hannah Victoria Sowers. Jacob Anthony Sowers. Irvin Jr. Stacy III. Parker Andrew Stollard. Chance Kadri Staples, Distinguished Scholar. Jenna Elizabeth Statton. Haley Paige Steffen, Distinguished Scholar. Trenton David Stifler. Haley Natisha Stultz. Chandler Thomas Sutphin, Distinguished Scholar. Hunter Hilton Tenson. Hannah Ray Terry. John Blakely O'Brien Thomas. Michaela Kathleen Thomas. Ayana Leela Tillery. Elian Steve Topanta Sanchez. Aliyah Kelvisha Tolliver. Sophia Catherine Trailer. Sunasia Asaya Turner Kaiser. Timothy Jean Tuttle, Distinguished Scholar. Samantha Solgetta Tyree. Madison Rebecca Ulry. Catherine Haley Vaughn, Distinguished Scholar. Janaya Shanae Vaughn. Kirsten Lee Vest. Berkeley Nicole Wall, Distinguished Scholar. Corbin Riley White. Diara Mikkel White. James Wyatt Whitlow. Benjamin Peyton Wilkins. Kendra Ann Williams, Distinguished Scholar. Tyler Shane Williams. Jeremiah Jamil Wilson. Kalasia Nashe Nicole Witherspoon. Jordan Christopher Wood. Austin Ryan Work. Sally Sabella Work, Distinguished Scholar. Amber Elizabeth Wright. Shauna Janae Wright.
Wow, what a class. Congratulations, seniors. At this time, it is my privilege to introduce to you your class president, Mr. Christian Crawley, who will lead you in a benediction.
I'd like to thank the Academy for this award. I'd like to thank my parents, the people who supported me, the fans. That's a speech for another day. If only words could describe how we all imagined this moment maybe 4 months ago when we entered the last semester of Salem High School, or perhaps when we started the school year in September, or maybe every September for the past 12 years before that, there probably would have been a lot less cuss words than what we might be thinking today. For me, I have been thinking about this day since June 14, 2016. It was on that day that I attended my brother's Salem High School commencement for the class 2016, just like I have here. And just like many of the classmates I'm addressing today did. After hearing the senior Salem singers perform their final number, after watching my brother cross the stage along with 276 other seniors, and after feeling the words of some of the graduate speeches, alumni like Ben Kennedy or Jake Preston, I knew that I had to be up on that stage doing exactly what they did with the confidence, class, and state championship level forensic skills they had. So, to make a long story short, yes, I have been planning this speech for the past 4 years. Now that that's out of the way, having been given the circumstances that has not quite been understood by any senior class president before me, I've come up with 10 rules to not surviving, but thriving at Salem High School. And yeah, it's definitely a little late to be handing out this kind of advice to a room full of seniors, but if you just hear me out, I think you'll understand why they're so important as we take our next step into college, the military, a job, or none of the above, depending on how well these vaccines are supposed to work. Number one, in all things, you can come up short and make a mistake and still climb higher than you were before, but it'll only be worth it if you take the risk and make the effort. From wherever you go to whatever you do, be your best possible self. You represent so much more than a single identity, and it's up to you to represent the whole of the group in the way you want it to be seen. The next one was written well before the protests that are currently taking our nation by force took place, but I think it still applies to the Black Lives Matter movement and every other movement that we will see and we will be heard from. Because if you truly believe in something, fight for it and demand the right thing to happen. Those who stay quiet will never get the opportunity to get what they want. Four, not everybody who you're friends with today will be as close to you a few years from now, and that does not make you, them, or anyone else a bad person because of it. As long as you find someone who will be there for you when it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, or even your year, you've got what you need. Five, commitment is vital in anything worth your time and is going to need time to sacrifice. And for that, only you can determine how you want to sacrifice that time. Don't back down from a challenge, because the right kind of pressure won't tear you down or split you in two, but will make a diamond instead of coal. Take your broken wings and learn to fly, blackbirds. Seven, You already know that there are lots of different kinds of people in this world, but there are still so many kinds of people in one community. People that we all must learn to tolerate, but respect them even if you don't agree with their opinions or methods. 8, change, especially in a time like the present, is difficult to accept because it was so easy to follow convention, to practice tradition, to stick to a routine. But change does not mean an end. Like the twin legs of a drawing compass coming apart to complete a circle, we will depart on our mission. But eventually, the compass will come together again, just like us. 9, always, always, always stay gracious for teachers who go out of their way, for friends who can stay by your side at your best and your worst, for mentors, captains, and confidants who want what's best in your best interest as well as the interest of the group, and for family who didn't make it easy, but unconditionally supported you in the face of uncertainty and trepidation. And number 10, don't procrastinate on your assignments, especially anything for IB English. All right, the actual rule 10, I lied. You will definitely procrastinate on lots of assignments, especially anything for IB English. But the one thing that you should not procrastinate on is making the most of the moment. Take every chance to make now your time to seize the day and live life according to your own terms, if and when possible. Even when it seems like you have 4 whole years to get through, just stop and look around every once in a while before the beauty of the moment is gone. If you haven't figured it out, these rules apply not only to the rising freshmen of the windowless, crowded, and sometimes wet Salem High School, but also the other rising freshmen of sorts who are partaking in this graduation ceremony today. To all my peers, I pray, that you will keep moving forward and proving yourself to everyone who has it, is, and will doubt. Your book only begins today because the rest is still unwritten. Thank you, Salem High School Class of 2020, for giving me and each other the high school experience that we can forever remember and use as a guide for the rest of our lives. Normally, this is part of the address where someone cites a quote along the lines of, you can change your hair, you can change your clothes, change your mind, say goodbye, hello, you'll always find your way back home. However, if there's one thing we all learned one way or another this year, tomorrow is never a guarantee. I hope I may see you all again sooner than later, but in case I don't get to tell you, I'll leave you with this. Like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood, or a ship blown from its mooring by a wind of the sea, who can say if we have been changed for the better? But because we knew each other, we have been changed for good.
Thank you, Christian. It is custom for us at our graduation ceremonies for the class president to pass our ceremonial mace on to a leader from the next year's senior class. So at this time, I'm going to invite Christian Crawley to take Salem High School's ceremonial mace and pass it off to Mr. Will Clemens, member of the class of 2021. All right, guys, it's time to get participatory once again. Seniors, this would be a good time to put your graduation cap on if you have not done so already. Also, make sure your tassel is on the right-hand side of your head, hanging down kind of awkwardly. Now, I'm going to, in just a moment, officially pronounce you as graduates, at which time you'll take that tassel and move it from the right to the left, as is custom. All right, guys, are you ready? Here we go. And I would encourage you, by the way, seniors, to stand. By the authority vested in me, by the Commonwealth of Virginia and the Salem School Board, I now declare you to be graduates of Salem High School. Congratulations, folks. No matter where you go and no matter what you do, never forget that you are Spartans and you are loved. At a normal graduation ceremony, we would now have our recessional and you would leave the Civic Center. We are still going to have a recessional of sorts. Folks, as you move into this world, you have an opportunity to make a decision about how you will live. Nobody except for you can determine how you will live. As we recess from this ceremony, I would like to encourage you to choose to live as a light. Whatever community you live in, whatever job you have, whomever you are around, I would encourage you to choose every day to be a light, to make the world you live in a little better, to make the world you live in just a little kinder by the way you love and the way you serve. My encouragement to the Spartans are to be a light.
In a time full of war, be peace. In a time full of doubt, just believe. Yeah, there ain't that much difference between you and me. In a time full of war, be peace. In a world full of hate, be a light. When you do somebody wrong, that needs change, make a difference. In a time full of noise, just listen. 'Cause life is but a breeze, better live it. In a place that needs a change, make a difference. In a world full of hate, be a light. When you do somebody wrong, line is 6 feet in the ground. In a race you can't win, just slow it down. In a world full of hate, be a light. Oh, when you do somebody wrong, make it right, make it right. Don't hide in the dark, you were born to shine. In a world full of hate, be a light. Yeah, it's hard to live in color when you just see black and white. In a world full of hate, be a light.
Friends, this concludes our corporate graduation ceremony. I look forward to seeing each of you graduates tomorrow at the Salem Civic Center Annex during your appointed hour, where I will have the true honor and privilege of handing you your diploma. Salem High School salutes the class of 2020. Congratulations to everyone.